Hello everybody, welcome back. I want to take a quick look at one of my favorite combat vessels today, the Super Hornet, and its capabilities in Star Citizen 3.0. For me personally, the Super Hornet has always been one of the best fighters in game, if not the best fighter, and I truly believe that in 3.0 is even better. Basically, the Super Hornet is the upgrade of the base Hornet and the closest we can get to the true military loadout in the Star Citizen universe. Whenever I think of combat, combat activities and general dogfighting, I always think and recommend the Super Hornet first. The truth is that the Super Hornet lacks any kind of utility, will not allow you to perform cargo or other similar activities, but it is a pure fighter, a pure combat vessel, and this is where it shines. It seems and feels like it achieves the perfect balance between agility, speed, sturdiness and firepower, and overall exceptional combat prowess. It is not the fastest vessel in Star Citizen, but its speed is perfect for a fighter of its size. Its SCM speed can go up to 230 meters per second, while its afterburner speed can go up to 1222 meters per second, allowing to the Super Hornet to excel in dogfights, but also pursue or chase away a hostile target. What really makes the Super Hornet stand out is the plethora of mounts it comes with. The default loadout might not be very impressive, but is the potential of greatness and superb firepower that makes all the difference. In total, the Super Hornet has 4 mounts, 3 size 3 on the wings and nose, and a size 5-1 for the ball turret above the hull. In its default loadout, it is equipped with 2 size 2 M4A laser cannons on the wings, a size 2 turret on the nose with 2 size 1 bulldog laser repeaters, and the ball turret with 2 size 2 badger laser repeaters. The combinations of weapons the pilot can experiment with make the Super Hornet a truly versatile combat vessel and a fearsome opponent. To complement its fighting capabilities, the Super Hornet also comes equipped with 2 341 missile racks with 4 size 1 marksman missiles each, 8 in total. The size 1 missiles are not that strong, but can cause some damage or distract your opponents long enough for you to deliver the killing blow, and like with the weapons, you can always replace them for stronger and deadlier missiles. For protection, the Super Hornet relies on 2 small shield generators. One of the many advantages the Super Hornet has over other fighters of its size is the second seat for a gunner that allows the owner to bring a friend along and increase the chances of success like this. Inside the cockpit, we can find 6 screens that will always display the most important info for you to monitor. And although 4 of these screens are easily accessible, the other 2 are placed above the pilot's head, making it harder to interact with them when in combat. The visibility is decent for a fighter, providing good situational awareness and a satisfactory control of the battlefield in front of you and around you. After all, the existence of a second passenger is only making things easier for the crew of the Super Hornet. Like with many other vessels in 3.0, the Super Hornet has a 3D radar to help with traveling around. Overall, the Super Hornet is an excellent fighter and my number one option for combat in the verse right now. An excellent choice for fighting pirates, performing escort duties and in general being the base of every military fleet, the Super Hornet is perfect for every player that wants to focus on combat-related activities in Star Citizen. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. I am Squid of Love and I will see you around the verse. Bye-bye.